Move over, Bobby Axelrod, you're not the only pugnacious redhead in AxCap's hallowed halls anymore. For a brief time during the wildly entertaining season 5 premiere of Billions, the truculent employees of both Bobby's company and its quasi-independent subsidiary Taylor Mason Capital unite to admire a surprise guest, the flame-haired Irish professional wrestler Becky Lynch, playing herself. Well, technically it's Rebecca Quinn, playing the same character she plays as a professional wrestler. Wrestling is complicated like that. At the end of last season, Taylor Mason's breakaway firm was brought back into the fold as part of an elaborate scheme, as if there were any other kind of scheme on this show, and tensions have been running high. After a staged fight with Wendy Rhodes, Maggie Siff, who one hopes will get more opportunities to beat people up on this show, Lynch tells the assembled traitors about the importance of doing the job, of allowing oneself to be humbled in the interest of the greater good. In professional wrestling, someone needs to lose in order to maintain the illusion that what's going is unscripted. Without a loser, no one could ever win. There's nothing more noble than taking a beating and making someone else look good for the good of the whole damn operation, Lynch says. I think it's clear that neither Lynch nor Wendy wants any of these people to roll over. AxCap is strictly a winners-only operation. The point is more that Bobby's people-powered view of the market and Maze Cap's mathematical approach both have their place. Their culture clash is counterproductive. Only when they start working together, and, yes, stepping back and allowing the other side to take the lead when necessary, will they be able to maximize their success. Of course, that's the explanation of the Axe-Maze relationship made available for public consumption, the pro-wrestling explanation, so to speak. The reality is much more complicated. Again, this is Billions. Quote closing parenthesis. Last season, Taylor Asia Kate Dillon slunk back to AxCap in defeat, company in tow, a fate accepted in large part because Chuck Rhodes, Paul Giamatti, Axe's old enemy, revealed to Taylor that he planned to come after Bobby, Damian Lewis, all over again and needed help from the inside. But with Brio that would be shocking on any other show, the script by the series creators Brian Koppelman and David Levien spills the beans on this arrangement almost immediately. Taylor comes right out and tells Bobby that Maze Cap is Chuck Rhodes's Trojan horse. For his part, Bobby is too perceptive to be surprised by this. Unless this, too, is part of Taylor's plan to get back at Axe. Perhaps feeling a bit too cocky now that he has officially unearthed Chuck's mole, Axe makes a big show of friendship by returning to Chuck the signed first edition Winston Churchill volumes he had previously purchased just to spite Rhodes. Bobby being Bobby, the gesture is meant as a quid pro quo.